AMD's Ryzen Threadripper has, for the time being, cemented itself pretty securely in the current high-end desktop market. It did this by offering consumers something that Intel didn't, more cores and threads for the price, all running at very decent clock speeds and a bunch of other cool features like more PCI Express lanes. In response, Intel announced their Core i9 family of chips, two of which should just about match or beat Threadripper in performance outright. However, the Core i9 chip that most closely resembles the raw specs of the Threadripper 1950X that we're using is the i9-7960X, which comes with the same core and thread count, but actually cost a whopping $1,699. That's about $699 more than the 1950X. There's no denying that Threadripper is an absolute monster. But let's not forget that it's only one piece of the performance puzzle. A great chip needs a great platform to work with, and X399 has that more than covered, but which X399 board should you go with? It's a decision that's usually dictated by what you're able to afford, but considering the price of the CPU you'll be pairing it with, you're probably prioritizing performance and features above all else, which is where the X399 ASUS ROG Zenith Extreme comes in, retailing at $550 in the US, or about 9,500 Rand here in South Africa. The Zenith Extreme is far from the cheapest option available to prospective Threadripper owners right now, but what you get for ponying up a little bit more extra cash for the Zenith Extreme is a feature-packed board that's almost unmatched in performance and appearance. And yeah, I know looks are totally subjective and all, but if you don't like the visual design of the Zenith Extreme, you're wrong. Just wrong. But let's not get into that right now. Instead, let's talk about what the Zenith Extreme brings to the table. Featuring the absolutely massive TR4 socket, not even the board's EATX form factor is able to make the socket seem less absurd. The Zenith Extreme comes equipped with 8 quad-channel supported DDR4 DIMM slots with a maximum capacity of 128 gigabytes and can hit speeds between 2133 and 2666 megahertz at stock, overclockable to a maximum of 3600 megahertz. This is probably a personal thing, but the DIMM slots are designed with an open-ended bottom and I can't stand it. It's something that more and more motherboard manufacturers have started to implement, so ASUS isn't at fault here, but it's just frustrating. I want a clip that actually comes over my RAM stick, not an open piece of plastic that I have to push on to know whether or not I installed them properly. Anyways, as I said, personal thing. As for expansion slots, you get 4 PCI Express 3.0 16 slots and 2 PCI Express 2.0 slots, x4 and x1 respectively, along with support for NVIDIA SLI and AMD Crossfire configurations with up to 4 graphics cards if you have a case big enough for it. An interesting thing to note about the board is its M.2 ports. It has one that's easily discernible, however, the board does include a DIMM.2 slot which lets you mount up to 2 M.2 SSDs to the card included in the box to go in that DIMM.2 slot next to the RAM slots. If M.2 SSDs aren't really your thing, you'll still get a respectable 6 SATA 3 ports. The Zenith Extreme is also equipped with either more USB ports than you'll ever need, or not nearly enough. And those USB ports include USB 3.1 Gen 1 and 2 in the Type A and C flavors, and even USB 2.0 just in case. Audio files are treated to the Supreme FX audio solution with dual headphone amps and Supreme FX shielding. The board also features a rich rear I/O configuration complete with ASUS's integrated I/O shield with all of the usual ports, two immensely useful buttons for clearing the CMOS and flashing the BIOS, the Wi-Fi antenna connections for both wireless AC and the ever so shiny brand new wireless AD solution, which I couldn't properly use since I have nothing in the office that's actually emitting a wireless AD signal, and then there's even LED illuminated audio jacks. The Zenith Extreme is also equipped with various interesting and useful ROG and ASUS exclusive features like an OC zone where you'll find great physical buttons and switches to make overclocking a little easier, and the Live-Dash OLED screen that displays important system information. It's hard to overstate just how cool and legitimately handy that Live-Dash display is. It lets you know if your system runs into any issues, helps you isolate said issues, and if you're feeling adventurous, you can set it to play back a quirky little GIF. GIF. JIF. Anyways, included in the box with the motherboard are the prerequisite cables, including 6 SATA cables, 3 thermistor cables, 1 RGB LED extension cable, and an addressable LED extension cable. The full list of accessories that come with the board is a long one, but highlights include a ROG DIMM.2 card that we've already talked about with a fan stand pack to go with it, a high bandwidth SLI bridge with 3-way and 4-way bridges also included, the ROG Ariane 10 gigabit Ethernet card, 2 Wi-Fi moving antennas, and so many stickers. Oh, and also a ROG branded coaster, because of course you get a ROG branded coaster. And to top it all off, there's the addition of a USB drive that comes with all of the drivers and utilities that you'll need. Neat. If you want to see an actual dedicated unboxing of the board, click the card right here to see my live stream build with this motherboard when I first got it. Great, Now that we know what the Zenith Extreme is, let's go over what it's actually like to use it. That's right, it's overclocking time. The Zenith BIOS is relatively easy to navigate and to understand if you've messed around with any ROG BIOS settings a few times in the past. If you've seen one Asus BIOS, you've kind of seen them all, sort of. If you're planning on overclocking your Threadripper chip or your high-speed RAM, and why wouldn't you, it's free performance, you'll find it super easy with the Zenith, whether you're an experienced overclocker or have no idea what you're doing. If you just want to set Threadripper to 4 GHz and RAM to its rated speed, it's as simple as changing the CPU core ratio and RAM frequency to your desired values. If your system seems unstable afterwards, you might need to adjust your voltages accordingly, but that's also a pretty streamlined procedure. But if you're the type who likes to tinker with each and every aspect of your computer, the Zenith has you covered too. The sheer number of tiny tweaks and changes you're able to make to the board, CPU, and RAM in the BIOS is almost overwhelming, but in a good way. But it isn't all smooth sailing. After getting everything set up, I got the 1950X up and running at 4 GHz with auto voltages and everything else on auto. The chip performed perfectly during testing and everyday use. But Ryzen, while being great on its own, is hyper dependent on speedy RAM thanks to its Infinity Fabric. So the default 2133 MHz RAM speed the board set for my G-Skill Triton Z RGB modules just wasn't going to cut it. I set the memory frequency to my RAM's rated frequency speed of 3200 MHz, set the voltage to a static 1.35 volts, and slightly adjusted timings, and nothing. The system would not pass post, and after a few resets, it reverted to stock settings across the board. I played around with voltages and timings even more and still couldn't get it up and running. The highest memory frequency I was able to achieve that was stable for the most part was 2666 MHz. I'm unsure whether the issue lies with Threadripper, the RAM I use, the motherboard itself, firmware issues, or just bad BIOS settings on my part, but while 2666 MHz isn't ideal, it's more than sufficient for my purposes. Keep in mind though, that was with all 8 DIMM slots occupied. When I did my live stream and only occupied 4 slots, 3200 MHz was no more difficult than just slapping the frequency into the BIOS settings. Future updates will almost undoubtedly smooth out issues exactly like this, just like they have on the mainstream Ryzen boards, so I wouldn't subtract that from the motherboard's review score, but that's not like we actually give out review scores anyways. Moving on! Aside from its well-designed look and smart layout, the X399 Zenith Extreme has another aesthetic trick up its sleeve, RG friggin' B. The board is adorned with 3 major RGB lighting zones that give the board some character and 3 RGB headers, one of which is completely addressable. The best part of all is that everything is Aura compatible, letting you sync up lighting effects across all hardware that supports it. Needless to say, all of that leads to some pretty spectacular light shows, especially with the live dash display running the Dinosaur Extinction Gift. It's by far the coolest one. Keep in mind, however, that one of the sections of RGB is actually integrated into the backplate of the motherboard and makes the board quite a bit thicker on the right-hand side. This may lead to some clearance issues in your chassis when you're installing it. I know for the Rip and Red build I did, the N3 Pro actually couldn't have the board screwed down on the side with the backplate because it pushed the side too far above the standoffs to actually tighten it down, so it was only held on by the left and middle screws. So be sure to thoroughly check your chassis clearances before picking up this EATX behemoth. But that just about wraps it up really. The X399 ROG Zenith Extreme is a spectacular Threadripper motherboard that's a little on the pricey side. It has a few minor flaws that likely stem from platform immaturity rather than systemic issues with the motherboard, so they don't detract from the experience of using it nearly enough to give them a second thought. The board also comes with all the bells and whistles you'd expect from the X399 platform, including some awesome handy exclusive features, and performs almost as good as it looks. What more could you ask for? And with that, I'm going to wrap it up there. Let me know what you guys think of the Zenith Extreme down in the comments below. Would you ever buy a motherboard that's this pricey? Any of you guys upgrading the Threadripper? Let me know down in the comments. Big thanks to Asus South Africa for sending the Zenith Extreme over for review. Be sure to smash that like button if you enjoyed this review, and be sure to hit that subscribe button while you're down there to stay up to date on all of our tech-related content. I'm Brett with the UF Disciple channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Cheers.